Do you like tracking your time? Do you like tracking your time with really nice applications that have great integrations and other things that I'm gonna show you in this video? Okay, keep watching. So diving right into Clockify, as we can see, there is a free version, and really quickly, just to show you the features of what they advertise, you can start timers, let people know what you're working on, do a bunch of different tagging and organization, edit the track time after it's made, mark it as billable, continue timers with clicks. This free app does pretty much everything you need, but from a pricing standpoint, the extra features are all outside of this forever free. I mean, you have so much going for you when it comes to the free version of this application that getting the new stuff is honestly not needed unless you're really doing a business. So as we'll see here, this is mainly administration or business based. There's basic, standard, pro, and then enterprise. And what you're really getting out of this is, you know, big bulk edits, adding time off and doing sort of invoicing and whatnot, and really having like managers be able to go through and integrate it with QuickBooks and those types of things. It's mainly for people who are trying to use it for business purposes, but for personal use, you're getting everything that you need here. First and foremost, if you want to manually add anything, you can go to the top here and type record videos or something to that effect, and I could add a project. And let's say I made a new project, which was Rize Productive, and made it so that it was red to get my color scheme going. And I could add a client if I had any there, or I could even make templates when I would upgrade to the next level. So if I press create, now after having created that project, what I can do is I could press start, mark it as billable or not, add different tags. Like recording, if I press control enter, it would make that tag. Then now it's something I can select and unselect. And then there's the ability right here to have it be manual add. So I can have it be for like, I would say it's from 5 to 7, or I can press add here and it would not have anything. But if I go back and go to this button right here, I then could press start or stop. So I can do record videos, select Rize Productive, and then start the timer. With this in mind, when I press stop, I am then able to go back and edit it. So let's say I was really recording from 5 a.m. to 7 a.m., which is accurate, or about 7:30 a.m. actually. This would change it to 2.5 hours on there, and that's really nice. You can then do a duplication here, or a delete right there, and then as you'll see, the different things that are the same names will stack on each other. But if I change this to record video, just even change a word here, it does not actually get it out of this stack, so you'd need to make a whole different entry for something not to stack on top of itself like that. So I would, if I wanted to get rid of one or the other, I would have to click on this 2 here, and then I could edit things and get it out of this stack. So I could go record video and then maybe edit video, change this tag to something else. So I'd get rid of this guy and put edit videos, or just editing. Control enter again, and then I would change this guy from 7:30 a.m. to 8:15 a.m. So as you can see, that is pretty much what you would do for basic time entries. If you want to make time tracking easier on yourself with time blocking, you can go to that integration right there and either connect to a Google Calendar or an Outlook calendar. So I'm going to connect to my Google Calendar. And for me, this makes it extremely easy. So I would select the different ones that I'd want. So I'm going to select all the main things on my calendar and then exit out of it. And then now what you'll see is that everything is popping up. So all I'd need to do in order to make something a time entry here, so if I wanted to track things and change things, okay, I'm really only going to be editing this until about then. I get to drag and drop all this, which is really nice, similar to that of a calendar application, which as many of you know is my favorite thing. So if I press this and do copy as time entry, I can either click right here and do it, or I can click on the thing itself and then it'll give me an option to do this, or just press start time entry and press copy as time entry. Now, what I can do is interact with it similar to the other section and actually have a place to put a description and whatnot. So if I go here and put growth, put create new project, have it color coded with what I want, select client, I would not have any. I could do templates if it was what I wanted there, and then press create. So then if I do this properly, what I then would have is a time entry with the project growth that is right next to what is on my time calendar. So this actually allows me to go through on a daily basis and see whether my life is in alignment or not. And you can change the view here from this week to last week, or just change it in general. You could have it be today only, which is a nice view for when you're doing it on a daily basis. And when working with applications like this, it's important to have basic functionality and the ability to go through and edit your different changes with ease. So I would really recommend going through and working on this application and even playing around with the dashboard and seeing what views would work well for you to show you how these different aspects of your life are made up and how maybe even time tracking from a business perspective could help if you're a small business. It has a mobile app that works very well and you're able to see things from a personal perspective, a team perspective, and you're able to see a dashboard, which I really think has solid functionality. And you can also make detailed reports in order to showcase how your different time was spent. So if you need to ever present this to a client, you can export the different things, show the billable hours. There's even the ability to round things, which is actually nice for those of us who want to make that happen. And the ability to filter in all these different ways in reports is good for data visualization purposes in general. It's also really good to visualize you going and watching this video. How do you improve your productivity even more?